This is Weather Center Live. Thanks so much for joining us this hour. I'm meteorologist Leona Brackett.
And I'm Nick Walker. We're getting ready to get into a busy weather weekend and the start of next week. Snow chances going up, and we even have the threat of some severe weather, too.
Oh, until then, we have the warm sticking around. Today, 195 million people above average temperatures. It's that warm weather that will help contribute to a foggy morning for a lot of places in the south. The roads anytime soon. Be prepared for some showers stretching from Atlanta towards Pittsburgh. We're seeing the next wave of rain heading your way. Behind it, drier weather, but until then, you have to deal with this little mess. Birmingham, Montgomery is seeing some showers. New Orleans, you're getting a little bit of a soaking. Atlanta, be prepared for those showers to be knocking at your front door. Actually, let's go ahead and take a live look at us. We're watching starting at 3 p.m. this afternoon Eastern time. We're looking at those showers right there. You see this blob of yellow and orange kind of inching its way towards Atlanta. Be prepared for some heavier to moderate showers as it picks up through this afternoon. We're going to continue to work our way through time. It kind of breaks up a little bit across Atlanta, but New Orleans, you're still kind of in a soggy mess. This is 8 p.m. Nashville, you're behind those showers as well. But be prepared as we see these showers inching towards the coastline as we get into 2. See that the showers are just inching towards you. So you had a lot of cloud cover, but notice those green spots right there. That's the rain, and it's going to be inching over you. It's not really causing any delays. It did cause some delays earlier, but right now you're in the green. But as we see the conditions deteriorate as we get into the afternoon, we're going to see it continue to push through about 5, 6, 7, 8 p.m. That's when you can expect all that rain to head your way, and then a little bit of snow farther to the north, but it hits the I-95 corridor closer to midnight tonight. Name fall to end with. I mean, we're gonna go ahead and take a quick look back at it, but don't those images make you want to go outside and enjoy it? It's still a gorgeous day outside today. For many of you, we're taking a look at this past November overall, the temperature departures. I mean, when you see these shades of orange and reds, that means we're definitely above normal from what we would normally be at. In fact, some of you have actually seen your top 5 warmest falls ever on record. So we're starting in the Northeast. These are the average temperatures you're looking at. Portland, Maine, you came in number 2 as your warmest fall. Burlington at number 1, Scranton at number 5, and New York at number 3. We're kind of working our way across the region, though. We're looking at the Midwest. Still very, very warm. I mean, some of you, Chicago, number 9, Louisville at number 9 as well, but Detroit, number 3, and so did Cleveland. You really ranked in pretty high as well. And in the West, I mean, you might be thinking, hey, they probably have seen some warmer falls, but no, not the case. I mean, San Francisco, you saw your second warmest fall ever. Phoenix, your second warmest fall. Tucson, check that out. Number 1, and so did Albuquerque, number 1 as well. While San Diego, you're at number 5, and Salt Lake City at number 9. So all this dry weather means that we do have to be concerned with the drought conditions out there. So unfortunately, we do have the drought monitor. This is coming back in September 1st. Looks pretty good, right? But as we work our way through October, now we're starting to see some moderate levels picking up across Arkansas and parts of Texas as well. And then it gets pretty bad as we get into right now. We're seeing some extreme popping up just south of Little Rock, unfortunately, and moderate spreading across the eastern seaboard. So this is the time when we do need a little bit of moisture, Nick.